The dust has settled in Texas, but the work to clean up after the world's most powerful rocket and get the next one flying in a matter of months is already underway. Elon Musk's SpaceX launched its fully stacked Starship for the first time, a little over a week ago. While the nearly 400-foot-tall vehicle flew for more than 3 minutes, achieving several milestones for a rocket of unprecedented scale. Starship also lost multiple engines during the launch, caused severe damage to the ground infrastructure, and ultimately failed to reach space, after the rocket began to tumble and was intentionally destroyed in the air. Elon Musk said today in Space Twitter, "It was good to fly this vehicle, so we can move on to more advanced designs. Booster 9 is more advanced. Starship Test Flight 1 was an amazing success, and the SpaceX team did a great job, and there was a tremendous amount of valuable information learned." As NASA Administrator Bill Nelson told the House Committee on Science, Space and Technology on Thursday that SpaceX blew a hole in that launch pad. The company hopes to launch another Starship rocket as soon as June or July. But the timeline depends on a variety of factors, including repair work, regulatory sign-off and the readiness of its next prototype. The next launch will utilize Booster 9 will be in 6 to 8 weeks. The highest hurdle to a second launch attempt may be the daunting cleanup. Soon after the launch, SpaceX began the process of cleaning up the launch pad and assessing the damage to its infrastructure. Photos taken by onlookers have shown the violent result of the Super Heavy booster's engines, which carved a crater into the ground and smashed debris into the launch tower, nearby tanks and other ground equipment. "I have asked, so I can report to you, that as of today SpaceX is still saying, that they think it will take at least a couple of weeks, to rebuild the launch pad, and concurrently about 2 months to have their second vehicle ready to launch." NASA Chief Nelson told lawmakers Thursday, providing the most recent update on the company's timeline for returning to flight. "The space agency has a vested interest in the success of Starship, as NASA gave SpaceX a nearly $3 billion contract in 2021, to use the rocket to land astronauts on the moon, as part of the Artemis program." SpaceX leadership repeatedly said before the launch, that not blowing up the launch pad, would be considered a success for the first launch. But the infrastructure still took a hit. In a series of tweets after the launch, Musk described slightly damage to the concrete launch pad. The company had built and said, he hoped that the rocket hadn't too heavily damaged the mount that supports it before launch. "All that's left of the concrete lateral support beam is the rebar," Musk said. The company CEO added that it was still early in SpaceX's analysis, but surmised that the force of the engines when they throttled up may have shattered the concrete, rather than simply eroding it. When SpaceX briefly tested the booster's 33 Raptor engines ahead of the launch, Musk said, the engines were only at half thrust, which avoided tearing a hole in the ground previously. One potential solution, Musk said, SpaceX is building a massive water-cooled steel plate to go under the launch mount. He said the plate was not ready in time for the first attempt and admitted that the company wrongly thought that the concrete would withstand the launch. SpaceX's launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration was a long-awaited final step to getting Starship off the ground, which makes the regulator's investigation into this first flight a key overhang to the second one. The Starship test flight triggered reviews from the FAA, which is effectively the lead federal regulator on the SpaceX rocket program. As is standard with a launch anomaly, such as this mid-air explosion, the FAA began an investigation into the flight and its fallout. The move grounds future Starship launches, until it closes the investigation and clears SpaceX to move forward under the license the regulator gave the company earlier this month. A return to flight of the Starship Super Heavy vehicle is based on the FAA determining that any system, process, or procedure related to the mishap does not affect public safety, the agency said in a statement on April 20, the day of Starship's launch and subsequent explosion. Additionally, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service disclosed this week that the Starship launch started a 3.5-acre fire on land, owned by Texas's Boca Chica State Park. FWS did not find dead wildlife on the local refuge lands, which are a habitat for endangered species, but found that the rocket's destructive force flung concrete and metal thousands of feet away and created a cloud of dust and pulverized concrete that fell as far as 6.5 miles from the launch site. One piece of SpaceX's second attempt is already largely in place, the production pipeline for another Starship prototype. The company had planned to launch the first Starship and Super Heavy booster flight as early as summer 2021. But President and Chief Operating Officer Gwynn Shotwell said recently that the inaugural flight was delayed in part because the company was focused on developing the production systems that will build the ship. The company has expanded its Starbase facility steadily over the past few years. Thanks to the many enthusiasts who livestream every minute of SpaceX's work in South Texas. It's apparent the company has as many as 10 further Starship prototypes in various stages of assembly, as well as up to 7 more Super Heavy boosters. Nelson touted as much before members of Congress, explaining how the company approaches rocket development differently than the space agency. Now understand that the explosion, that's not a big downer in the way SpaceX does things. They are hardware rich, meaning they've got a lot of those rockets ready to go, and that's their modus operandi. They launch, if something goes wrong they figure out what it is, they go back and they launch it again, Nelson said. As with any rocket development program, and especially the largest ever assembled, SpaceX's timeline for the next Starship flight is likely to evolve and change. The goal for the next flight is to make it to staging, succeed in staging and go into orbit. My expectation for the next flight is it's more likely to reach orbit than not, said Elon Musk. The next launch will utilize Booster 9 will be in 6 to 8 weeks. Booster 9 is exceptional as it has isolated engines. Elon explained that 9 will have a more robust design due to these engines. The engines will start faster, throttle up faster and leave the pad faster. Another significant change is that Booster 9 will use electric motors instead of hydraulics. The electric motors will be more isolated and less likely to fail. Elon highlighted the Soviet Union's N1 program. The Soviets were onto their A game, they were fantastic and their motivation was maximized. Still, the N1 failed and never reached orbit. N1 is the closest to Starship of any rocket that has ever flown. The cryogenic fuel is actually more risky than kerosene used by N1 and by Falcon 9. It was too expensive to continue, and was probably embarrassing on a national level, so they stopped the program. The Soviet N1 used kerosene-based rocket fuel in all three of its main stages. Falcon 9's first stage incorporates 9 Merlin engines, and aluminum-lithium alloy tanks containing liquid oxygen, and rocket-grade kerosene propellant. In contrast, Starship Super Heavy Booster is powered by 33 Raptor engines, using sub-cooled liquid methane and liquid oxygen. Elon took time to explain to listeners that it is important to stay on the path to becoming a multi-planetary species. We live on a planet with strong gravity, and it takes a lot to leave our planet. To get to Mars and Starship is a real path to get us to Mars, and that is mind-boggling. We need reasons to wake up in the morning and feel excited about the future.